This is the life.
It feels amazing. I love getting married in Alaska.
I hate this spinach.
Whoa.
Look at you!
Welcome to the Yukon Northern Light Viewing Set!
Wow!
Once, in 2016, me and Constantine decided to go to Alaska. Sounds like a really good idea. It's been a while since we've been there. Let's go again.
Thank you, have a good day.
A quick flight with the beautiful view on Mount Rainier, and here we are, Alaska, the last frontier. It's midnight, but it's now dark in Alaska in June. Kahilna River, it's gorgeous. Oh yeah, this is gorgeous as well. Let's go to Talkeetna first. That is where, usually, the adventures begin. It does look great. But it is too relaxing, and this is not what we want. How about we go to Taiga?
This is much more like it.
Aha!
And of course, it cannot be without famous Talkeetna Air Taxi.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It simply means that serious adventures are awaiting for us. Quick hitchhiking almost instantly gets us to even more famous Paul Roderick. Him and his flying machine is almost ready to take us to the unknown. Are we ready? The time will tell. Know this, though. The places we are going to go right now are so remote that for hundreds of miles there is nobody around. The only help we can rely on is our own. And hopefully Paul can get us there, because his helicopter is too small. And it really requires the mastership and craftsmanship of flying to get us to the point we're going to. After hours of flying, miraculously, we are at the spot we needed to be. Total remoteness. Nobody around. Nice. Goodbye, Paul. Goodbye, helicopter. We might not see you ever again. Unfortunately, we did not bring much food with us. Bummer. And that is why we completely depend on fishing, gathering berries, and killing animals. Unfortunately, we forgot the rifle, so we can't kill anything. Well, it's all good. Let's drink then. To your health, comrade. Next morning, the adventure continues.
Come on, Constantine, you can do it.
Hey, that was not promised.
And this amount of mosquitoes was not promised either. Let's scare them away. Unfortunately, only deer was scared away. As for us, we want to explore more of this unknown to anybody land. Hopefully, on the way back, we can find our tents. We could barely see them anymore. It's our third day in these tundras, and the weather was not that great, and it's not getting any better. In fact, it's second day, pours, rain cats and dogs. I guess it is time to use our satellite phone and call for help. Finally, the support is here, but visibility is so bad, it's indescribable. Dry cabin at last.
Hey Paul, where is the sunny Talkeetna?
There it is, fellows.
Let's get there, then.
What a nice feeling to step on the holy ground.
And now, let's dry everything out and go walk regularly.
Hello, Mike.
Hey, what's up?
Mike. My name is Ken, traveling from New York to Alaska, through the United States.
How's that?
Wonderful.
It is wonderful and sky high beautiful. Sky high because we're flying the drone. It's nice that we have it with us. And right upon coming back to Earth, the view can be seen right from railroad station, astonishes me. All three, the most famous Alaskan summits. In fact, on the summit of this mountain, I've been successful a few times previously. This ground is dangerous. You could see it by the graves of the aviators, elks wearing hats, and previous climbers. But we are not up to said stuff today. We just want to enjoy the Talkeetna walk. Too bad we don't have much time to walk at will. Gotta hurry. We only have 2 weeks and the plans are superb. First, we need to get to Denali National Park. It's much easier to see it from the flying distance. Drone always helps in that. We should be there pretty shortly, but we have to go all the way around those mountains. That is why we're trying to drive as quick as possible. The speed is right about 110 miles an hour. Luckily, in Alaska, nobody cares about it. But we cannot possibly drive all the time, have to hike once in a while. And here, from the summit of Mount Margaret, we could see the whole park. But then, suddenly, right next to the beautiful hotel, we've got really scared.
The wild unknown awaits you behind every corner. The big flying thing, and you're doomed.
Considering really big Alaskan distances, we're trying to do everything very quickly. Quick fish cleaning, fast soup cooking, and even faster, getting ready to sleep. Oh yeah, the soup is delicious. It's only midnight, but in Alaska, it's never dark. Except the winter time, of course. So, we have plenty of time to fly the drone and see where are we. Evidently, we are about 60 miles north of Fairbanks, right on the top of the Eminent pipeline. Next morning, the weather is fantastic. We are lucky bastards, with the exception of a little bit of mosquitoes. Finally, we are at the beginning of
rough, brutal, and very unpleasant James Dalton Highway. This place was never very hospitable. Can we endure the gravity of the situation?
I guess we can. It ain't so bad. Looks very, very pleasant, familiar, and homey.
Pipeline. It's nice and expensive.
Looking closer, the highway is not really a highway. It's more like a jeep trail, just dirt, mud, and nothing. And these local fellows, we could see every other minute. This guy must be hungry.
Hey, Mike. Looks like we are after the Arctic Circle again.
Looks like we are. The cold is coming.
Looks like the avalanche is coming.
cabin as well. I personally don't mind cold as much as the rest of the stuff and bad things which are waiting for you on this highway. Finally, we are at the Etigun Pass, right in Brooks Range. I wonder, how do we fix the tire? So far, looks like this is the only mechanic available from around. To fix a flat cost us 95 bucks, a little steep. Late night, we reached Yukon River again. And here, we found a local trapper who will take us into the deep woods.
We're getting to the tough part right now. Right coming up is the Tus Ox. We got about a half mile to do, and then we're to the trail and the wooden log bridge.
Six miles without any trails, with plenty of mosquitoes and real high temperatures, was pretty tall order, even for real men. We already bushwhacking for over 2.5 hours, but we are not there yet. Barely, very barely, we get into the cabin, but I have a hunch it will be no air conditioning in there.
Welcome to the Yukon Northern Light Viewing Center, and come on in.
Local trapper Jeremy is 35 years of age. He still lives with his mother. Must be Alaskan thing. Nice fellow though.
Man, I'm tired.
You think I'm rested?
Early morning, in spite of sleepless night, we continue traveling on the canoe. It's nice and refreshing. Moment like this would be pointless without the drone experience. By the way, we just came from there. That was fantastic, but I'm not that proud of our Jeep being that dirty.
Look, Constantine, this is the right place to catch a beaver. Try it. Probably didn't catch one. Too bad.
Instead, for 20 bucks, even in Alaska, you could get a beer with the sandwich.
Delicious.
And the place we're having lunch right now, called Hit and Run. 3 people, 5 houses, and around for about 300 miles, there is no one. A minute later, the dusty Dalton Highway gets us back to the Fairbanks. Finally, the car wash. We follow Highway 3 now. It goes to the south. This road follows Chugach Mountains with the spectacular summits. According to plan, in about 5 hours we should arrive to Wrangell National Park. The views of Wrangell National Park may admire even a raccoon. This you don't see from a kitchen window. But from this kitchen window, you may actually see it. Long day. I think we deserved a hotel room, and after a little break, let's fly. What you just witnessed happens to us daily. Too much mud on the road. This is the kind of a vehicle you have to drive in these places. Meanwhile, we're getting towards River Matanushka and Gletscher Balabushka. Still cannot believe the weather we're having. Usually it's different here. But not just the weather, the views are also splendid. And this looks just the place to make a couple of pictures. Any place possible, we catch fish, driving and enjoying alpine historical parks. This way or the other, we need to be in Homer tonight, because we reserved a ferry to Kodiak Island from Homer. Meanwhile, we still get a couple of hours to hike a bear mountain, from where magnificent view to Copper Lake and Copper River is breathtaking. Unfortunately, the weather didn't hold very well. No wonder we're driving towards the ocean. Homer, at last. It's just a small port. There's not much here. All it is, it's a big ocean strip with numerous shops and very nice places to eat. And, of course, for any casual observer, it's obviously this is the end of land. Our ferry. Wonderful views out of the cabin window and very comfortable bed. Good night, fellows. Next morning, the world famous port of Kodiak. Strange bird, but the views are phenomenal. Without any hesitation, we decided to take a walk in the very wet forest. After about 45 minutes of walking and getting soaked wet, we fed up with that. Instead, we decided to catch a fish. Done. The fish is caught, put on the table, clean, prepared, well fried, and eaten. After such good meal, the brain is not functioning well. Next day began wonderfully. The city of Kodiak from the air can't be anything better. After the flight, we decided to explore all the roads of Kodiak Island. Literally, all of them, because it's only three, with the total length about 50 miles. It ain't much, but considering lots of wildlife all over the place, our speed is very slow. And even though the coast scenery is magnificent, there are not too many people live around here. They have no covenants rules, single dirt road, extremely strange habits, even stranger signs, and one single post office which is open one day a week. There is nothing around here, and from the abandoned landing strip, only bees take off. Time to leave cozy Chiniyak and go towards Pasakshak. Pasakshak, which is even more remote than Chiniyak. This is in fact not the end of land, but the end of everything. In such moment, better be prepared for the worst. Meanwhile, conquering Alexander Kashivarov's peak sounds like a really good idea. True, beautiful scenery, fresh berries, but we are not the only ones who want to conquer Alexander Kashivarov's peak. A huge group of British Green Berets share the trail with us. Man, what a view! Kodiak. Oh boy, what a view! Mosquitoes! Doesn't matter, we're 20 minutes from the top of the mountain, enjoying birds and saying farewell to poor soldiers who will be stuck here for about 2 weeks. Quick descent, goodbye eagle, we're heading north. Next place to visit, world famous, the Bay of Anton Larsen. Another hour of dirt roads and we're heading up without any trails to the summit of Mount Sharatin. This is not Sharatin, this is Konstantin. And that is not Konstantin, that's an aeroplane.
I don't like this spinach, Mike.
And what is this?
Nah, nothing to worry about, just a bear, no biggie.
This sure is true. Let's better go home, cook some fish. Fair enough. We're back to Kodiak. Looks like the only thing people think about here is cleaning the fish. Well, we're not gonna be breaking the habits. Let's clean the fish as well.
That's a big fish!
Yep, can't complain.
After a stuffy meal, there is nothing better than take a walk and fly the drone around. Originally, being Russian ourselves, it's kind of cool to see that in Kodiak City, everything is founded by Russians. Russian churches, Russian inn, Russian habits, Russian Constantine, Russian birds. Unfortunately, we have very little time left here. Really want to enjoy everything around, including the drone experience right on the bay. Time to go to a big land. Alright, let's finish the beer and go. A moment later, very fast ocean boat with a strange name, no jumping, get us back to Homer. Farewell, ocean, hello, docking station. If you want to see the most awkward architectural structures, you should visit Homer someday. As for us, we don't really want to visit Homer anymore. We're going north. What we want to see though is Sheep Mountain Lodge. It's very hospitable. They even give you the wheelbarrow. After preparing and eating real quick snack, there is nothing better than participate a wedding.
So, how it feels like to be married in Alaska?
It feels amazing. I love getting married in Alaska.
That sounds great.
Beautiful.
Alaskan wedding, liters of vodka. How could you not fly the drone after that? Our next destination is McCarthy. It's only 27 people live there all year long, and it's located between Wrangell and St. Elias National Parks.
Hey, Constantine, is it your cat?
Maybe. Nah, probably not.
Meanwhile, locals go loco. This guy almost got stuck, then he got unstuck, then the other guy got stuck. This guy wanted to unstuck the first guy but got stuck again. Forget it, let's go further. Now, not all the bridges in Alaska are very dependable. If you look at this bridge from the side view, it doesn't look that good. In any case, before we even think once or twice, we are here, McCarthy, and it is tall. Not tall, high, but you have to pay the fee.
Oh, just walk?
6 cents of a mile.
McCarthy was founded at the beginning of 20th century. The main deal was always the Kitticott mine, the most profitable mine in the history of the United States at that. But of course, to make sure it is the truth is to take a look from the air.
That wasn't so bad. But after all that, how about we take the real aviation? Shall we? Yes, we shall.
It is easy to make a flight like this look great because the landscape's incredible.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Long flight. I'm tired. How about take a little climb? To, for example, Bonanza Mine.
Good idea. Let's do. It's only a 7-hour hike. Fantastic hike. Let's go home now. After the hike, good meal. And then, the traditional glacier flight. After such a long day, what a pleasure to have some vodka with Russian fish soup. Mooses most likely will not desire much of our fish soup, so we'll eat all it ourselves. Meanwhile, we go through another 1,000 miles and get very close to the village Valdez. Valdez is the biggest port of Alaska. This is the south end of Trans-Alaskan oil pipeline. Nice spot though, where the weather is always bad, but the people always smile. We only have a couple of days left in Alaska, so we're trying to find the hotel and then go into a little scenic tour to explore the close-by valleys. Numerous waterfalls are all over the place. Old mines, old avalanches, old everything. Alaska. Next morning, our last day. How about to finish it up with the world famous Bay Trek? So be it. Hello, Bay Trek. Goodbye, Alaska.